Hello students, today we are going to study one of the most important method to find out mean, which is step deviation method. For this we will solve first question from exercise 14.1. Here it is the question. From following survey, find out mean number of plants per house. Number of plants and number of houses are given. To solve this sum will require 5 columns. First column will be of class, that will take from the question itself, which are 0 to 2, 2 to 4, 4 to 6, 6 to 8, 8 to 10, 10 to 12, and 12 to 14. Third column is of frequency, that also will take from the question itself. These all are the frequencies that we'll write in the third column that already I have written. Now we'll sum up these all frequencies. It will be 20. So sigma fi will be 20. Sigma stand for sum, fi stand for frequency. Sum of frequency equals to 20. Let us move towards second column, which is of class mark. It is represented by xi. The formula to find out class mark is lower limit plus upper limit divided by 2. For this class we are having lower limit 0 and upper limit 2. Let us substitute this both value in the formula. So here lower limit is 0, upper limit 2 divided by 2. So 0 plus 2, 2 divided by 2, it will be 1. So class mark of first class will be 1. Now to find out class mark for the second class, we'll find out class length, which is represented by h. Class length is nothing but the difference of two consecutive class. If I take class 0 to 2 and 2 to 4, for this class upper limit is 2 and here upper limit is 4. 4 minus 2, it will be 2. So we are having class length 2. It is not necessary to take first two class only. You can take any two consecutive classes. If I take these two class, then here upper limit 8, upper limit 10. 10 minus 8, 2. 14 minus 12, 2. So to find out class mark for the second class, we'll add this value of h into previous class marks. That means 1 plus class length 2, it will be 3. For this class, class mark of previous class plus class length 2, it will be 5. For this, class mark of previous class plus class length 2, it will be 7. Same way, 7 plus 2, 9. 9 plus 2, 11. 11 plus 2, 13. So here second column is over. Let us move towards fourth column, which is ui equals to xi minus a upon c. In this column, first of all, we'll find out center or middle observation of this class mark. So let us find out how many class mark we have. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 class mark we have. So which one will be the middle one? This 7. So this 7 will take A. So value of ui for this A will be 0. Above 0, value of ui will be minus 1, minus 2, and minus 3. And below 0, it will be 1, 2, 3. Let us move to fifth column, which is fi into ui. These all are the fi, then frequencies, and here it is ui. We'll multiply this both. So 1 into minus 3, it will be minus 3. 2 into minus 2, minus 4. 1 into minus 1, minus 1. 5 into 0, 0. 6 ones are 6. 2 twos are 4. 3 threes are 9. Now add these all negative numbers. 3, 4, 7. And 1, 8. Here it will be minus 8. Now add positive number 6 plus 4, 10 plus 9, 19. So here we will find out sigma fi ui. Sigma stand for sum fi ui, sum of fi ui. It will be 19 minus 8. 19 minus 8 will be 11. Now let us solve this sum by applying the formula, which is mean x bar equal to a plus sigma fi ui upon sigma fi into h. Let us substitute all values. Here we have a 7 plus sigma fi ui 11 upon sigma fi, that means sum of frequencies, which is 20. And height h, that is 2. So let us reduce this. 2 tens are 20. It will be 7 plus 11 by 10. So it will be 7 plus 11 by 10 will be 1 plus 1.1. Now 7 plus 1.1 will be 8.1. So here mean x bar is 8.1. This is our mean. Check it out, whole sum. Thank you.